Bring me a higher love. Bring me a higher love. Oh. I have this thing where I get older, but just never wiser. Midnights become my afternoons.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our 2024 new student orientation program leaders. Please welcome our esteemed Columbia University alumni. Thank you. Please stand to welcome our Columbia University faculty, staff, and participants in today's convocation ceremony.
Please be seated. Thank you for all the student spirit. It's just incredible. Good evening. Yes, student spirit. Good evening to all of you, and thank you for joining us here today. My name is Jessica Marinaccio, and as your Dean of Undergraduate Admissions and Financial Aid, and as the person who signed all of the admission letters that you worked so very hard to earn, I want to officially welcome you to the Columbia community. You're finally here! Joining me on stage here today are Interim President Dr. Katrina Armstrong. Provost Angela Olinto. Executive Vice President for Arts and Sciences, Amy Hungerford. Dean Sorett of Columbia College. Dean Chang of Columbia Engineering. The list is long. Dean of Religious Life, Ian Rottenberg. Sherry Wolf, President of the Columbia College Alumni Association. Columbia Engineering Alumni Association President Reed Ellison. And I know we're going to get a loud round of applause for this. And new student orientation coordinator, Kaden Berkman. From Kaden very, very soon about his experiences at NSOP. Also joining us today are distinguished alumni, esteemed faculty, dedicated staff, and committed, and dare I say, very enthusiastic student volunteers. All gathered here for the purpose of welcoming you on this special day for our entire university community. Special because convocation is the ceremony when aspiring Columbians finally become truly Columbians. Welcome, class of 2028. Today, your first official day at Columbia, is the culmination of years of effort, accomplishment, and dedication. A day when it may seem that your hopes and dreams have been fulfilled. But in fact, this is a day when hopes and dreams just begin to take place. Because education, especially at a place like Columbia, is about inquiry and challenge and promise and change, leading to new hopes and even bigger dreams that you may not yet, even now, know exist. This evening, you stand on the cusp of an experience that will change your life. Consider the loved ones beside you and those wishing you well from afar. What they all share is the desire to support this incredible journey that you embark upon today. And of course, family and friends, this is a big day for you too. A challenging one in some ways, maybe, but one which I hope you will embrace with great joy. And so we proudly welcome you too to the Columbia family. New Columbians, as you begin your journey with us, you will have a number of guides to assist you along the way. And I'd like to take a moment to introduce several of my colleagues who, along with their offices and staff, support students in making the most of their Columbia experience. And if I could ask the staff that will be introduced, you know who you are, to stand all at once, please. And this includes Lisa Hollibaugh, Dean of Academic Affairs for Columbia College. Barclay Morrison, Professor of Biomedical Engineering. And Vice Dean of Undergraduate Programs for Columbia Engineering. Jenny Mack, Senior Associate Dean of Undergraduate and Graduate Student Affairs for Columbia Engineering. Andrew Plaw, Dean of Advising, who heads the James H. and Christine Turk-Barrick Center for Student Advising. Shannon Marquez, Dean of Undergraduate Global Engagement. Roger Laheka, Interim Dean of Students, leading undergraduate student life. And Stephanie King, Associate Dean for Student Intervention and Family Engagement. Our entire staff will be a tremendous resource to you, and we hope that you will reach out to those who are introduced, as well as the people who work with them over the course of your 4 years here. Class of 2028, You sit before me because in all the tapestry of who you are Columbia. Your Columbia story begins today, and as someone who knew you a little bit at the beginning, I will watch how that story unfolds with great anticipation and admiration. Welcome again, amazing, amazing class of 2028. Thank you. Before I introduce our next speaker, I just want to announce a small change to the printed program that you have before you. Kaden Berkman will be introducing... we'll be producing Dr. Katrina Armstrong. So we will flow through the program. Just follow along with that one change. With that, I have the great pleasure of now introducing you to Reverend Dr. Ian Rottenberg, Columbia's Dean of Religious Life and Director of the Earl Hall Center for Religious Life. Please join me in welcoming Ian to the podium.
Welcome. It is an honor and a joy to welcome all of you to Columbia for this time of convocation. This space that we enter marks a point of transition. We honor and celebrate all of your individual journeys, merged now into a new class that takes its place within this great university. The talent, dedication, hard work, and endurance that have brought you to this moment are breathtaking. The love, care, and commitment of your family are inspiring. You are joining this university at a time of immense challenge. Tension and division have strained the fabric of our diverse communities. You are well aware of this. Columbia is uniquely challenging in this moment because our world is uniquely challenging in this moment. But Columbia is uniquely positioned to respond to these challenges because of the one gift that no other institution in the world has. That gift is this community of great leaders, scholars, faculty, and students, which is now joined and enhanced by your presence. All that makes you individually beautiful and good joins with your classmates and becomes part of the fabric of this place. This empowers us to renew, to repair, to grow, and to heal. Today marks a new beginning, filled with opportunities to demonstrate the power of community in the face of great challenges. Welcome to Convocation. Welcome to Columbia. Thank you. Now it's my honor to welcome someone who it sounds like you already know a little bit. Kaden Berkman is the student. I will welcome Kaden Berkman to the stage.
Do you hear their enthusiasm? I don't know if it's carrying through the whole tent, but it's really, really loud up here. So thank you guys. Welcome to Columbia. It is my honor to speak here on behalf of NSOP and aid in your introductions to a new home. You've worked hard and your dedication have propelled you through stormy waters to this moment at Columbia University. Convocation serves as an inflection point in your lives, at which you are faced with abounding possibilities, each no more tempting than their counterparts. At points such as these, you may find yourself overwhelmed with the immensity of it all. If there are so many avenues to explore, how is one to determine right from wrong? The next 4 years will be pivotal in this journey, allowing you to chart your own unique pathway through your schooling, your career, and life. But before you fully embark on this journey, please take a moment and join me to give a very warm welcome and thank you to our crew captains, orientation leaders, committee members, resident advisors, all those who have made your first day at Columbia this experience we see here today. This year's NSOP theme, Dive In, is entirely about not holding back and fully immersing yourself in the community we see here today. Coming into a new environment can be a nerve-wracking experience. With so much to take in, to learn, to familiarize yourself with, you may enter the water with trepidation, barely tipping your toes in. At first, the water may be fiercely cold, cautioning you to step back onto safe land. But when you continue treading into the water and acclimatize, you begin to learn the comings and goings of the tide. You develop a sense of familiarity that fully embraces you. My parents are both high school teachers on military bases around the world, so naturally, I moved around throughout my childhood, living in the United States, Turkey, and ultimately Germany, where I graduated high school. As I moved through these different waters, as I moved through these different waters, I found varying communities composed of completely different elements, some rich with diversity and acceptance, some too large to ever truly know their full extent, some small and tight-knit. But despite these differences, each environment afforded me an opportunity for growth and change, providing me the necessary ability to find my niche and embrace my new community. Coming to Columbia was no different. Move-in day was not only my first time in New York City, but also my first time on the East Coast. Exactly. With that being said, though, I naturally was feeling a little bit out of my own depth, trying to tread water, but surely feeling the strength of the undertow beneath me. Given the wide array of experiences incoming students bring to Columbia, I was nervous about finding community. But lo and behold, community is ever present. During my NSOP, shout out co-op, I met some of the most amazing people who immediately uprooted all of those concerns, some of whom are still a large part of my life today. As NSOP came to a close and the academic year was heralded in, I began to make friends in my classes, in my extracurriculars, even in my dorm, each their own independent community, but all contributing immensely to my personal growth and change. As I've continued my time at Columbia, it is this robust community of students that has continually shocked and invigorated me. Though we have our fun tensions, Columbia College versus the School of Engineering, Columbia versus Barnard, co-op versus all the other immersions, we can step back. Ooh, tension. Exactly that. With all these tensions, though, we can step back and we can recognize that lighthearted rivalries exist in such abundance as a result of a rich community of respect, support, and compassion that we share amongst ourselves as students. In the past year, this community has collectively been put through a great deal of harm. Yet through the thick of it all, this community has remained resilient and intact. I see students advocating for one another, coming together to show support in ways I had never conceived as possible. I witness people of all backgrounds brought together by empathy, by care, demonstrating the strength and integrity that epitomizes my Columbia. I am so excited, class of 2028, to welcome each of you to that community here tonight. After tonight's ceremony, you will finally have the opportunity to meet your orientation leaders face to face I can promise they're excited to see you. As they introduce you to the Columbia community and to NSOP, you will learn what it really means to navigate New York City. Whether that be immersing yourself in the rich culture of fine arts with arts and media, engaging in social justice dialogue and activism through CARE, navigating the intricacies of the Big Apple with Explore New York City, and last, but surely not least, learning early the value of a relaxing trip in nature with co-op. On behalf of the committee, the crew captains, the orientation leaders, we are so excited to dive in with you. Thank you all. It is now my pleasure to introduce the interim president of Columbia University, Dr. Katrina Armstrong. President Armstrong joined the Columbia community in 2022 as the Dean of Vagelos College of Physicians and Surgeons and CEO of Columbia's Irving Medical Center, the first woman to serve in both positions. She continues to serve as the CEO of CUIMC while interim president. Throughout her career, President Armstrong has been an advocate for eliminating health inequities and building a healthcare system that serves all communities with compassion and excellence. Please join me in giving the interim President Armstrong a warm, warm welcome.
Before I begin my remarks, can we give Caden and the NSOP team another round of applause? Like, woo! Wow! I spent the morning with them, and they are the most remarkable group of student leaders I have ever met. Caden, congratulations. Good evening. I am thrilled to welcome you, the students, families, and friends of the class of 2028 to Columbia University. Welcome. I think as we've learned by now, today is clearly a day for celebration, a day for celebration and reflection as we honor the hard work that our students and families have put into getting here and prepare some of our newest Columbians for the world they will enter. Of course, as I stand here, and as I'm sure this is true for many in the audience, it has to bring back some memories. For me, it brings back some vivid memories of my first days as an undergraduate. And as Caden and I have shared several times, we both grew up moving around a lot. For me, from London to Indiana to Buffalo to Tuscaloosa, Alabama. I went to middle school in a trailer in Northport, Alabama, driven by their incredible belief in education. My parents found an extraordinary high school in Birmingham where I became a boarding student in 10th grade on a full scholarship. It was that high school, a high school called Indian Springs, that changed my life. It is because of that high school that I was able to get into a lesser university in a town called New Haven. You may have heard of it. I traveled to my move-in on a train by myself. My parents would have loved to have been there, but they couldn't afford the trip. Some of you here may be in that situation today. My mother sent me with a trunk, though, a trunk that she covered in fabric by herself fabric from my childhood bedspread, a chunk that we've moved with me ever since. My life from Indian Springs to Yale to medical school at Johns Hopkins and everything that has come after. Those experiences have made two fundamental truths clear to me, very, very clear to me. The first is that we live in a society that could be so much better. And the second is that education is the single most important thing we can do to get us there. Our newest Columbians, here you will learn from the finest faculty on the planet, live and work with the greatest students you will ever meet, and benefit from the dedication and experience of the most incredible staff you will find anywhere. Woo! And mind you, this is all located in the greatest city in the world. Columbia has been going about our work for three centuries, and we're going to continue to do that work for centuries to come. Throughout this long history, we've gone through some very challenging periods, including in the recent past. What we do today, how we approach the future, must be grounded in those lived experiences. The COVID pandemic not too long ago devastated our city and our community. The personal and communal loss was heartbreaking. And the past year has brought grief, anger, upheaval, fear to the forefront. So many in our community have felt unheard, abandoned, or betrayed, have felt the harm that Caden described. And for that, I am deeply, deeply sorry. As we look ahead now to the new academic year in front of us, we must both take time to recognize this history and understand its implications as we redouble our commitment to the future of this incredible Columbia community. To do so, we have to be clear about who we are, how we see our mission, and how we define our values. On Friday, I sent a letter out to our Columbia community that affirmed our priorities. Let me share with you what I shared there. The central mission of this university is to impart, create, and advance knowledge. This mission is grounded in a commitment to free expression, open inquiry, and generous debate. To do this, we must, as Caden said, create an environment of inclusive pluralism where all our members can thrive. Violence, intimidation, discrimination, and bullying, any behavior that affects our teaching, learning, and research are antithetical to the world and who we are. Everybody must be engaged and know that their voices matter here. Protests must be managed effectively and fairly. We know that that requires holding two truths at once. The truth that our mission depends upon free speech and open debate, and the truth that our mission equally depends upon an environment free of harassment and discrimination where our students and the class of 2028 can learn. There is no doubt that holding these two truths requires understanding and effectively implementing our policy rules and procedures just as it does in the society around us. I know that none of this will be easy or straightforward, but I also know that Columbians are exceptionally good at doing the hard things and that we can and will do them with integrity, empathy, and respect. So I want to finish by sharing my hopes with you for your time here. I hope that you learn. I hope that you learn from your professors about the subjects that most excite you. I hope that you learn from your peers about different ways of being in and thinking about the world. And I hope that you learn from this incredible city about the richness of diverse cultures, the value of finding you in conversations, in moments that surprise and captivate you, and maybe most importantly, the absolute delight of catching an express train on the subway when you thought you had to take the local. Congratulations and welcome to Columbia. So I am so delighted now that I get to introduce Sherry Wolf. So Sherry leads our Columbia Alumni Association. She is a graduate, and you guys need to clap with this, from the College of 1990. Let's give her a round of applause. She was involved as an undergrad dormitory council board of managers on the senior committee. She was the president of our Alumni Association since 2023 and has been integral in so many things we've been doing here. Our Dean's Alumni Task Force, Columbia College Women, I think that needs a round of applause. And she's on the board of directors for Columbia Barnard Hillel. Sherry, we're so grateful that you're here with us tonight. Thank you so very, very much.
Thank you, Dr. Armstrong, for that very warm welcome. And welcome to the class of 2028. My name is Sherry Wolf from the great class of 1990, and I'm president of the Columbia College Alumni Association. On behalf of the more than 50,000 Columbia College alumni, welcome to Columbia College. 38 years ago, I began my own Columbia journey and was sitting where you are today. Columbia looked very different in 1986, but just like you, I felt all of that excitement of finally being here. Today is really about new beginnings. As the British novelist Mary Wollstonecraft once said, "The beginning is always today." And while the path ahead may seem unclear, that is where the excitement lies. And so, as you begin your journey, I wanted to share three pieces of advice to encourage you to make the most of your time on campus. First, you have to understand that the people you meet at Columbia are going to be the most important part of your Columbia experience. It starts at NSOP, and every class you attend, every club you join, every question you ask, it all has the opportunity to create a new connection with professors and peers. Whether the classmate sitting next to you today ultimately becomes your lifelong friend, your business partner, or even your partner in life, you are all going to be bound by your experience as Columbia Lions. Second, embrace the core curriculum. Yeah! The core is unique to Columbia, but I actually don't think I truly appreciated its value when I was a student. So you should understand that it is going to connect you with all future students and all former students. It's going to open you up to a new way to look at the world and prepare you for a world that is constantly changing. And third, and I'd like to say most importantly perhaps, Get to Know Columbia College Alumni. We want to get to know you. We're here to be your mentors and your advisors, to provide you with connections, opportunities, and experiences. The Columbia College Alumni Association has so many programs to connect alumni with you. And in fact, you can start tonight by signing up for the Odyssey Mentoring Program when you leave your event. Make us a part of your experience from day one. So remember, your Columbia journey will define not only your time at Columbia, but also the person you will become. The beginning is today, and the possibilities are endless. On behalf of Columbia College alumni, welcome to the Columbia family. It is now my pleasure to introduce to you one of the inspirational people who will lead you on your journey, Josef Sorett. He is the... He is the Dean of Columbia College and Vice President for Undergraduate Education. As the Chief Academic and Executive Officer of the college, Dean Sorett's central focus is on ensuring that students have the best possible experience inside and outside the classroom. The Dean stewards the college curriculum, which includes the core, as well as other academic co-curricular and programmatic services that form the foundation of the undergraduate experience at Columbia. Dean Sorett has been a member of the faculty at Columbia since 2009. As a scholar, he has published 3 books along with many more academic articles and popular essays. His most recent book, Black as a Church, Christianity and the Contours of African American Life, came out in 2023. His work has been recognized with both a Lenfest Distinguished Faculty Award and a Presidential Award for Teaching Excellence. In addition to contemporary civilization in the core, Dean Sorett has taught a range of courses in religion, politics, the arts, and African American studies, including a spring 2024 class that explored the intersections of religion and hip hop over the span of the last 50 years. In all of his classes, students grapple with profound questions about culture, community, and difference, and they are challenged to think critically about the ideas, individuals, and institutions that have shaped our world. Prior to joining Columbia's faculty, Dean Sorett was a fellow at the W.E.B. Du Bois Research Institute at Harvard University, where he also completed his PhD in African American Studies. Lastly, he lives in Morningside Heights with his wife and 2 teenage sons. Please join me in warmly welcoming Dean Sorett.
Thank you, Sherry, for that warm introduction. I'd like to echo others in welcoming our new interim president, Dr. Katrina Armstrong. Thank her for joining us. Yes, let's thank her for joining us here at her first convocation. Want to acknowledge Provost Angela Alinto, who is also here for the first time at Convocation. Let's give her a round of applause. And a special thank you to the faculty, university leaders, staff, and alumni with us tonight. One last extra measure of gratitude in appreciation to our NSOP orientation leaders. Perhaps you've heard them. Thank you, NSOP. Thank you, lifers, for showing up for our newest community members, for showing us all what it means to be a Colombian, for extending to them the warmest of welcomes at the start of this new year. Thank you, ENSA. You have my respect and admiration, and frankly, I'm a bit in awe of your ability to keep up this level of enthusiasm, not since this morning at 8 a.m., but since yesterday at 8 a.m. To the class of 2028, parents, family, and friends, I'm honored to welcome you tonight on behalf of Columbia College. Tonight, in this moment and in this company, is an opportunity for you to reflect on who you are and all the things you carry with you to this new beginning. I want you to hold in your mind not just your accomplishments and academic aspirations, but your passions, your humor, your creativity, your fear, and your anxieties and hopes for the future, and even perhaps a few regrets from your past. The entirety of a life that only you will ever truly know. Whatever you believe, whatever you hold true, and however you define yourself, this campus and this community is now your place, your home. Each of you is integral to it. The things you carry are singularly yours, even as they are essential to the us that is becoming, an us that is strengthened by the opportunity to learn from and with each other. We will ask much of you over the next 4 years, and you will ask much of each other. To excel here, inside and outside the classroom, is neither easy nor a given. But for tonight, I have just two basic thoughts that I want to share with you that I believe will serve you well during your 4 years in Morningside Heights. Follow your curiosity and cultivate humility. My own undergraduate experience began as an aspiring basketball player leaning towards a pre-med pathway. I went astray quickly. But I carried with me a set of ideas about race and religion that had been formed while growing up in and around Boston, Massachusetts. Go Celtics. All right. Before I could name those ideas clearly, they were challenged as soon as I landed on campus in Tulsa, Oklahoma. What was ostensibly then a foreign country to me. Those experiences over time bloomed into a series of questions that stayed with me after college on a circuitous path through graduate school that eventually led to Columbia. Questions that continue to enliven an abiding passion for teaching and learning. I don't share any of this to advocate for a life in academia or to dampen anyone's hoop dreams, but rather as a tangible reminder to follow those sparks of curiosity when they ignite inside of you. Hold on to that curiosity. Take the risks attendant to following where it leads and share it with us while you are here. And while here, you may come across the work of physics and mathematics professor Brian Green. Some of you know him. You may meet him when he lectures in Frontiers of Science in the core curriculum. His writing on the nature of the universe offers profound yet basic insights. He reminds us, and I quote him, that the boldness of asking deep questions may require unforeseen flexibility if we are to accept the answers. As a community, Columbia is in the midst of season grappling with a number of deep questions. Questions about war and conflict, the privileges and burdens of free expression and its limits, and about our shared humanity. Questions about the nature and purpose of the university itself and our obligations to each other in this context, and about the hard work it takes to ensure, as President Armstrong so aptly put it, that ours is a campus in which every Colombian, students, faculty, and staff, irrespective of where one falls across the lines of identity or ideology, is both fully welcomed and able to pursue their work free of harassment or discrimination. The kind of flexibility that Professor Green encourages is integral to that work, which brings us to my second thought. Cultivate humility. To succeed at Columbia takes a particular skill set. It takes embracing an obligation to listen closely and carefully, to prioritize the learning that is not yet finished and we came here to do. It takes seeking out understanding and remaining in conversation with divergent ideas and points of view, particularly when it's uncomfortable. And it means re-engaging with respect even when we fervently disagree. All of this requires humility. The core curriculum is meant to be a training ground to cultivate these habits, which we strive to develop in our students. The books you will read are not blueprints. Faculty are not gurus intended to guarantee answers or propagate a viewpoint. Rather, the questions you encounter, the views that challenge you, the ideas you explore will and should change your sense of yourself and the world around you. You cannot and will not go through these things alone. And the promise of the core truly is found in the collective engagement with that difference of opinion and viewpoint and interpretation, that is, with each other. Fulfilling that promise requires humility. Yes, we will ask much of you, not the least of which is this delicate dance between curiosity and humility, or to put it another way, recalling Professor Green, the gumption to ask deeper questions that challenge established dogmas and the flexibility to accept unexpected answers. All of this requires respect for yourself, for those around you, and for the structures and spaces that make this exploration, this very community, possible. And as you look for your own answers, challenge yourself with some questions. Are you willing to disagree, to admit to being wrong? Are you willing to stand up? But are you willing to sit down and listen? Are you open to having your mind changed? Every one of you deserves to be seen, heard, and valued. But just as that obligation is owed to you, you owe it to every single member of this community you are entering, the us that we are together. I believe that we are up to this. I believe in this community, the curiosity that led each of us here, and our capacity for humility. And it's my great privilege as dean to welcome each of you as we partner in this work of learning, of growing, and advancing the cause of our collective humanity. Before I take my seat, I'd like to take a moment just to offer my deepest appreciation to the parents, the families, the friends who are with us tonight. I've not yet sent my own off to college. I have a couple more years. But as a parent, I know something of what it means to trust the care and education of our children to others. The people on the stage, the people here at the front, and the hundreds of staff and faculty who make up the community here at Columbia take our responsibility to care for your students with the utmost seriousness. It's not a charge we take lightly. I thank you for your trust and the continued love and support you will provide, and for the remarkable young people that you have brought here this evening. And so, class of 2028, with your orientation ahead of you and 4 years of exploration, discovery, and memories to be made, good luck, and let's go. So I now have the pleasure, before sitting down, of introducing my colleague, Amy Hungerford, the Ruth Fulton Benedict Professor of English and Comparative Literature, who serves as Dean of the Faculty and Executive Vice President of the Faculty of Arts and Sciences. Please join me in welcoming Dean Hungerford to the podium.
Thank you, Dean Sorett, and welcome class of 2028 and your families. Welcome on behalf of the faculty that you will meet in many of your classrooms. People may say, and you may feel, that you are coming to Columbia at a historic moment.
This era of cultural foment has been likened to other times of transformation, the student movements of the late 60s, or the peace activism following World War I. And both those histories shaped Columbia. Our core curriculum was founded in response to the First World War to strengthen students' readiness for democratic citizenship. And the student protests of 1968 and the university's healing afterwards set norms for activism that we still live with today. But the history you may feel most keenly right now is your own. All that you brought here, along with your pillows and shower caddies, these things include your knowledge and skills from high school, expectations shaped by your family and friendships, cultural intuitions born of the places you've lived, and a working ethics rooted in your decisions and your reflections on them. This historic moment is first and foremost a feature of your history. For you and your families, the achievement of arriving here is both an ending and a beginning, the fulcrum of your changing life. Because of that other historical moment, Columbia's, the world's, you will hear much about pluralism and about learning from conflicting points of view. The activities that we associate with a growing mind, we might think of reading, reasoning, listening, analyzing data, learning context and history, all of these sit at the very heart of the university's mission. And Columbia is designed above all for this work. Your studies will change your mind. In my own reading this summer, I became interested in just this question, exactly how minds change. I want to credit a book and a friend for spurring me along. The book is called How Minds Change by a man named David McCraney, and it was recommended to me by a friend who graduated from Columbia College in the 1980s. McCraney synthesizes several strains of research in the science of cognition and social change. He shows how a changing sense of belonging is where a change of mind begins. The research shows that change happens in the feelings before it happens in the beliefs. Kindness precedes persuasion. I will admit, this truth is difficult for me. I believe in and love the freedom of changing my mind. And it feels always to me like something intentional. At 18, I came to college intending to make a difference in the world through education or environmental policy, I thought. I chose to major in political science. I know the chair of poli-sci is here too. But then came poetry, specifically a teacher who introduced me to poets who seemed to speak in a voice that I had been hearing somewhere all of my life. And those poets led me to more poets and other teachers, to writing and research, and to the life of an English professor. It was an intellectual journey, to be sure. But in all of these transformations, belonging to a university came first. I love the fact that universities are made to foster changes of mind, to step over any shame or sense of being wrong. Here we embrace the earned reality of a better argument, better data, a new question that makes our whole understanding suddenly shift. It's electrifying. It's continuous. And it is worth pausing on this counterintuitive fact. In many communities, common views about the world bind the group together. But here's the amazing thing. The community of the campus is held together by the shared view that beliefs are always a work in progress. Here, to signal a desire for continuous learning is to signal that you belong. And you can learn a whole lot more about how all of this works in the human mind and in society from our world-renowned faculty: psychology, behavioral economics, philosophy, neuroscience, literature, religion, and more. Class of 2028, my wish for you on this evening is that you live out a Columbia identity in every classroom. Take joy in this special place where you belong, not because you agree to a popular opinion or a particular truth, but because you want to change your mind. Thank you.
My name is Reed Ellison, class of 2008. I'm the current president of the Columbia Engineering Alumni Association. And on behalf of the over 50,000 living Columbia Engineering alumni, it gives me great pleasure to congratulate you and welcome you, the great class of 2028, to Morningside Heights. Today you will join one of the most influential academic communities in one of the most dynamic and engaging cities in the world. You begin a rewarding educational experience that'll stay with you forever. I have no doubt that Columbia and our engineering school will play an integral part in your lifelong pursuits, and that all of you will lead the way in creating innovative real-world solutions that will forge a stronger and more equitable society. Columbia faculty are world-renowned for groundbreaking research and scholarship. New York offers unrivaled energy, culture, industry, and will also serve to enrich your academic experience. And of course, you, our students, are among the best and the brightest. In your time at Columbia, I ask you to be mindful of your own needs and leverage all the resources that are available to you at this great institution. There are clubs, sports, study sessions, the Career Center, and many other resources that will help you here at Columbia. And most importantly, I want you to have fun. As you forge into this new chapter, build friendships and connections. They will be part of your support structure as you navigate your studies and beyond. Your academic experience at Columbia will be framed by this amazing city. Take advantage of all it has to offer. Visit different neighborhoods, go to the museums, relax in the parks, and try new restaurants. Beyond the city and this great institution, the Columbia Engineering Alumni Association is committed to supporting you both during your time as a student and after. There are many programs and events offering the opportunity to meet with and socialize with alumni, and I encourage you to take a part of that. These are alumni who will come back and give you advice on experience of choosing a major, career advice, or supporting you in your pursuits beyond Columbia. I hope you will take full advantage of the tremendous resources available to you, and you'll place priority on having fun and making connections along the way too. Welcome to the Columbia community. Now it is my distinct pleasure to introduce Shih-Fu Chang, Dean of Columbia Engineering. And the Morris and Alma Shapiro Professor. He leads the education, research, and innovation mission of the school and has greatly contributed to the growth and advancement, propelling it to one of the top engineering schools in the nation.
Hello, welcome. Welcome to Columbia University. Welcome, class of 2028. It's really an exciting time for you, your family, and for all of us. Today, you are not just starting a program of study. You are joining a special, vibrant, and enthusiastic community. Enthusiastic, right? That's a So I've been at Columbia for 31 years after I get my PhD degree from a university in a town called Berkeley, California there. And I'm a proud father of two daughters who have graduated from Columbia University. So with that, I can assure you, you have made the right choice. There's no other place like Columbia. As the Dean of Engineering, let me just say a few words about this amazing school. From the beginning, Columbia Engineering has been a school engaged in New York City and the world. Columbia engineers helped design the first subway line in New York City. That's the number one subway. Although it's a local train, not an express train. We'll wait for the express train. You will use it many times over the next several years. FM radio was created right here in Philosophy Hall, just right to you, by Edwin Armstrong, who was an alum and a professor. The machine that was developed to count national census data was invented here on campus and later on led to the creation of one of the best known companies called IBM. So Columbia Engineering continued to develop many, many important technology innovations, and that spirit of innovation continues today. You will have the opportunity to work alongside faculty and your peers in the lab on the most exciting groundbreaking research. We have created many, many centers in many topics, including artificial intelligence, data science, biomedical engineering, quantum computing, climate prediction, and many other topics. You will thrive in this unique, really special environment. In this environment, our engineering students and Columbia College students have a unique opportunity to learn from one another with shared passion, respect, values, and empathy, as has been described by President Armstrong. For our engineering students, you will benefit from the renowned Columbia core curriculum and liberal arts courses, giving you a broader and deeper perspective. For the college students, you have a chance to take courses from a world-class faculty in engineering field. Many of them are here today. Thank you for attending this. It's important. Give them a round of applause. This unique offering is a true strength of our university. Our computer science faculty work with faculty in humanities and social science to create cross-disciplinary courses called Computing in Context. Some of you may have taken it. These courses, These courses connect computer science and engineering discipline with broad fields like social science, history, art, biology, public health, policy, and more. And now we're expanding it to cover new topics called AI in Context. So stay tuned. Engineering now affects every discipline, and every discipline affects engineering. And there's so much to be learned from this interdisciplinary field at Columbia, this special environment. I know our students care deeply about the world around them and the future. Columbia will offer to you an amazing environment to learn together, grow together, understand together, explore new ideas to become problem solvers and agents of change who display integrity and humility as described by Josef earlier. Our school vision, Engineering for Humanity, will guide us on this important path. There's so much each of you can do to fulfill this important vision and make a positive impact. Perhaps you invent a new technology at the makerspace, in a design challenge, or at a hackathon, or in a venture competition to create a new company. You might discover a new passion by participating in a club like the Columbia Space Initiative, Robotics Club, Engineers Without Borders, Women in Engineering, or the Formula One Racing Club, and many, many more. There are so many possibilities and opportunities that await you and all of us. So this is truly amazing community, and you are now part of it. Let's take this time before the classes begin to get to know one another better and prepare for this wonderful journey. And you have our wonderful orientation leaders from NSUP team to support you. And special thanks to our alumni who returned to campus today to join all of us to celebrate the achievement of our newest class of students. Let's give them a round of applause to our special alumni. Again, congratulations to all of you, class of 2028. Welcome to Columbia.
Come on up. Here we go. Yes. Thank you, Dean Chang, for those wonderful remarks. It's my privilege to bring with Dean Chang back as we will welcome two students to the podium to lead our newest Columbians in reciting the pledge and code of honor. Yeah! First, I think. First Dean Chang, and then we'll.
I think they would read that way.
We're introducing them.
I see. Got it. So let me introduce Kavika. Kavika Krishnan is a Columbia engineering senior from Ashland, Massachusetts, majoring in computer science. She is the current student body president of Engineering Student Council, ESC. And her presidency served on the council as the vice president of policy and class of 2025 vice president.
Mariam Jallo is a senior in Columbia College from Portland, Oregon. She's currently studying history and political science. She served as the freshman and sophomore class president, vice president for finance, and is now Columbia College student body president for the 2024-25 year.
Hello. We are honored to be here today. One of the roles of your student body presidents is to help facilitate the creation of academic policy within our respective schools. We are here to serve any and all academic needs or requests from students.
Through the work of the student councils and with the encouragement of the student body, both Columbia College and Columbia Engineering constructed a pledge and code of honor to help foster a community of academic integrity and to help remind us of the importance of honoring one's work while in college and going forward.
Incoming students have already completed their academic integrity tutorials online and have signed their honor codes electronically. But to officially welcome you to our academic community and complete an important Columbia tradition, we are now going to introduce the pledge and the honor code.
Please turn to the back of your programs, class of 2028.
Yes.
I ask that you now stand and recite the pledge with us in unison.
Woo!
The undergraduate students of Columbia University hereby pledge to value the integrity of our ideas and the ideas of others by honestly presenting our work, respecting authorship, and striving not simply for answers, but for understanding in the pursuit of our common scholastic goals. In this way, we seek to build an academic community governed by our collective efforts, diligence, and code of honor. Please remain standing while we lead you in the reading of the code of honor.
Please recite the code of honor with us in unison.
I affirm
that I will not plagiarize, use unauthorized materials, or give or receive illegitimate help on assignments, papers, or examinations. I will also uphold equity and honesty in the evaluation of my work and the work of others. I do so to sustain a community built around this code of honor. Thank you.
Thank you. Great job. Thank you.
Well, hello again. My return to the podium means that we are nearing the end of tonight's ceremony. I know, you want to take next steps. In addition to giving a final thanks to our wonderful student leaders, I would also like to recognize the staff within Columbia College and Columbia Engineering and throughout the entire university who made today possible. So could we give them a round of applause, please? And of course, thank you again to all of the parents, family, and friends with us tonight at this truly special occasion. And to the incredible class of 2028, and believe me, I know that you're incredible. Thank you for choosing us. We are honored to have you here in our community. Now, before we end, I would like to remind everyone that students are due to meet their orientation group directly following this ceremony. After the academic recessional, we ask that parents, families, and loved ones all take a few moments to say goodbye for now, as students depart to officially begin NSOP. And now, to close our program, I would like to invite the Kingsmen to... The Kingsmen to lead us in singing our fight song, Roar, Lion, Roar. You will soon learn this by memory, but you will find the words on the back of your program, so please join in and let's give a big round of applause to the Kingsmen.
Nowadays we can praise fighting teams again. Hear the lion roar his pride while the men of Morningside follow the blue and white to victory. Roar, lion, roar, and wake the echoes of the Hudson Valley. Fight on to victory evermore while the sons of Knickerbocker rally around Columbia. Columbia, shouting her name forever. Hudson Valley, fight on to victory evermore, while the sons of Knickerbocker rally round Columbia, Columbia, shouting her name forever. Roar, lion, roar, from a martyr on the Hudson shore.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please remain in your seats until the stage party has recessed. Families, it is now time to say goodbye to your students. New Columbia students, after that time, please proceed to Upper Campus to meet your orientation groups. Thank you and have a great night.
Down in Tribeca, right next to the Narrow, but I'll be hood forever. I'm the new Sinatra, and since I made it here, I can make it anywhere. Yeah, they love me everywhere. I used to cop in Harlem, all of my Dominicanos right there up on Broadway. Pulled me back to that McDonald's, took it to my stash spot, 560 State Street. Catch me in the kitchen like a Simmons whipping pastry. Cruising down A Street, off-white Lexus, driving so slow, but BK is from Texas. Me, I'm out that Bed-Stuy, home of that boy Biggie. Now I live on Bill. And I brought my boys with me. Say what up to Tata. Still sipping my top. Sitting courtside, Knicks and Nets give me high five. I be spiked out, I could trip a referee. Tell by my attitude that I most definitely from
New York. Hey. Concrete jungle, yeah. With dreams of fate. Oh, it's nothing you can't do.
Yeah.
Now you're New York. These streets will make you feel brand new. New lights will inspire you. Let's hear it from
you. Welcome,
OG. New York.
I made you high. Catch me at the X with OG at a Yankee game. That made the Yankee hat more famous than the Yankee king. You should know I bleed blue, but I ain't a crypto. But I got a gang of walking with my click though. Welcome to the melting pot. Corners where we selling Africa been by the home of the hip hop. Yellow cap, gypsy cap, dollar cap, holla back. For foreigners, it ain't fair. They act like they forgot how to act. 8 million stories out there in the naked city. It's a pity half of y'all won't make it. Me, I got a plug special ed, I got it made. If Jesus paying LeBron, I'm paying Dwayne Wade. Three dice CeeLo, three card Marley. Labor Day parade, rest in peace Bob Marley. Statue of Liberty, long live the World Trade, long live the King. Yo, I'm from the Empire State. That's blinding. Girls need blinders so they could step out of bounds quick. The sidelines is lined with casualties who sip the life casually, then gradually become worse. Don't fight the apple Eve. Caught up in the in crowd, now you're in style. And in the winter gets cold, in vogue with your skin out. City of sin, it's a pity on a whim. Good girls going bad, the city's filled with them. Mommy took a bus trip, now she got a bust out. Everybody ride her, just like a bus route. Hail Mary to the city, you're a virgin. And Jesus can't save you, life starts when the church in. Came here for school, graduated to the highlight. Ball players, rap stars, addicted to the limelight. Empty in May, got you feeling like a champion. The city never sleeps, better slip you an ambient.